Hello, is it the private investigating, please?
Yes, it is.
Yes,
This
sir.
is
Can I pl
Gladys. How can I help you?
Yes, sir, please, sir. Can I speak to the private investigating?
Yes, this is Gladys at Accurate Investigations. How can I help you?
Yes, sir, please. I hope you can help me. My name is Mario. Many years ago, my friend and me, we robbed the bank. We robbed the bank. And we get a cart, but my friend, he buried the money.
Hold on, please.
He hid the money.
Okay, can you please repeat that?
I said many years ago, me and my friend, we robbed the bank, and before we go to jail, he buried the money in the Mississippi somewhere. And he did not tell me where it is in the Mississippi. It is hidden somewhere, $5 million United States money. And he died in the hospital without telling me where it is hidden. So I wondered, could I have the private investigating to find the money for me, please?
Okay, well, just hold on a second, because I didn't have a chance to get my pen and paper. Hold on a second. I'm going to grab my pen and paper so I can take notes. I was in the other room. Okay, I'm sorry, sir, because if I don't write things down, I don't hear, I don't remember. Okay, what was your name, sir?
Yes, my name is Mario.
Mario?
Mario, M-A-R-I-O.
Okay.
And you want me to tell you everything what I told you before again?
Yeah, that would be helpful, yeah.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Well, I don't know exactly how many years ago, it was about nearly 20 years ago, me and a friend of mine, We rob a bank, not in the Mississippi, it was in another part of the United States.
What bank was it, sir?
It was the National. And,
it was a national bank?
Yes, sir. And it was in New York, but that isn't the problem. The problem is that before we got caught and sent to the prison, my friend, he hid the money somewhere in the Mississippi. Now,
right.
He did
Who
not...
Who is your friend?
Sorry?
Is your friend still in prison?
No, my friend, he's died in the prison.
Oh, okay, friend died in prison. What was his name?
His name was Anthony.
I'm sorry?
Anthony.
Oh, Anthony, okay.
No, Anthony.
And what was his last... Okay, and what was Anthony's last name?
Hopkirk.
Oh, boy, you'll have to spell that for me, Mario.
Oh, I'm not too good at the spell. Please forgive me. I'm not too good at speaking English or a spell English.
Okay.
I think it's a H-O-P. It's either C-O-K-U-R-K. Hopkirk.
Hopkirk, okay.
Yes, sir.
All right.
Okay,
and what was your last name, Mario?
My last name is Giovanni Neapolitano.
Okay, you could spell that one for me. It's Italian, I know, but I just can't spell it.
Yes, it is a G-H-E-I-H-A-V-A.
Oh, wait a minute. Going too fast. G-H.
G-H-E.
Yeah.
I.
Uh-huh.
H-A-V-A-N-H-I is the first part of my last name. And the the second part of my last name is N H E O P O L I T H N O.
Okay, so that's not Italian, is it?
Yes, sir. No.
Oh, it is Italian.
Yes,
okay,
sir.
That's what...
I am from the Italy.
Oh, you're from Italy. Okay.
Yes,
what part of Italy are you
from? I moved
from?
To the United States, I many, many years ago now. Yes, sir.
Okay.
But I am in the Mississippi now.
Oh, you are? Okay.
Yes, sir. I am live in the Mississippi.
Okay. But where do you live? What county?
The zip code is 39212. And my address is 34, number 3, number 4, Hopper Avenue.
Hopper Avenue. And what city is that?
I can't remember. But I just moved here. I have not got too much information. I have only just got out of the prison. But the thing is, my friend, he died in the prison. So I needed a private detective to find out if he can or she can, if it is a man or a woman, I am not knowing. It might be you, I do not know. But I need to find out where he did hiding the money from the robbery.
Yeah. All right. Well, can you give me your phone number, Mario?
I have not got the phone number.
How am I going to call you back? How am I going to call you back?
I'm calling you from the kiosk.
Oh, from the kiosk?
Yes, sir.
Are you going to be getting a number that I can reach you at, or?
Well, there is no phone. As I say, I have only just moved in to this house one day yesterday. And just got out of the prison. So,
okay.
You know, I have not got anything sorted out yet. I have not got a job. I am not going back to crime. Definitely not going back to crime. But my main thing I need to do at the moment is to find this, I can't remember it, $5 or $6 million. We stole $5 or $6 million, and my friend, he has hid it somewhere. I do not know where, and he cannot tell me now because he is dead now.
Right. And
we were sent to a separate prison, so I did
right.
not even see him since the day of the being in the court with the judge.
Right. So what prison did you end up in, Mario?
In New York.
Okay, so you were in the federal prison in New York?
Yes, sir.
What was the name of that prison?
I don't know. I cannot remember. I do a lot of reading for the Italy. They got me the Italy books. And
I'm sorry, Mario, but I'm a little confused.
When I was in the prison, I keep away from other people because there's a lot of a fight, and it is terrible. So I kind of don't mix with anybody. I keep myself to myself and just read a book because they get for me the books.
I understand that.
I don't
sir.
Know if they get it from the Italy, but it was written in the Italy, yes, sir.
No, I know, but what I'm saying is that you don't know the name of the prison that you were in?
No, that is not the immaterial. The thing is, all I am interested in now, that is history. That is a gun, that is something that is gone.
Okay, let me explain something to you.
I have don't get me wrong, I have not broken out of a prison.
They let me out. Yeah,
I did not break out. Don't think I broke out of the prison.
No, I don't think that.
It's just that I have made my way back to the Mississippi, and I have found the little place to live. It is a little apartment, and I do need to get my hands on this money.
Right. Well, in order for me to help you, Mario, I have to be able to confirm your story. I need to know what city you're living in, and I need to know what prison you were in. Because, you know, as you can imagine, we get calls all the time, and some of those calls are, you know, interesting, to say the least. And
interesting? I'm sorry, but I do not understand what you mean, interesting.
Well, in other words, we have to verify.
Oh, I see.
What prison you were in, and I need to be able to call you back on your phone and verify that you are a real person with this situation and not someone just playing a trick.
Oh, yes, I get your saying. Yes. Well, I have not got a phone or anything.
Okay, what city are you living in?
Sorry?
What city do you live in?
All I know, it is in Mississippi. I get the ride. I get a ride in the big lorry. The man, he gave me a ride to the Mississippi.
Right, well, what's the city that you're living in?
I only got here yesterday morning. I do not know.
What you're at the kiosk right now. Ask somebody in the kiosk what city you're in.
There is nobody around here at the moment.
Okay, that's a little bit strange to me that you don't know what city you're in and you have an address.
Well, I did get this address. This is not the silly call you say about. This is the definite call, and I need this money because I did the prison. I did the prison for a lot of years, and I don't want it to be the fact that I did it at the prison for nothing. You know,
right? My
friend, he has hid the money somewhere in the Mississippi. I do not know where. This is what I need to try and finding out, so I can get my hands on the money that we stole from the prison, and then I will be able to buy myself a new house with a telephone and everything else. But as I say, at the minute, I don't even know whereabouts I am in the Mississippi. I have only got here because the zip code, that is, I couldn't think of what it was called now, the zip code.
39212.
39212, yes, sir. It is a...
Okay.
I think it might be a Jackson. Is it a Jackson?
Okay, Jackson. All right, so do you think it'd be a good idea for us to meet then, Mario?
You want to meet me?
Well, that would be good, don't you think?
Yes, sir. Yes, that would be good.
Okay. All right. Let's see. This is Easter weekend. How about we say sometime on Monday? Would that be good for you?
On a Monday? Yes, sir. That is fine for me. I've got nothing else to do. But not too far from where I am, because I do not know anywhere in this area. I've never been to the Mississippi before. So, you know, maybe you could come to my house, or maybe I could meet you somewhere near my house.
That'd be fine. Where, let's
Well,
see,
my
where, what's
apartment, I
the,
should say, not the house. You know what I mean.
what's the close swap shop or something in your house?
Could you repeat this, please? You're breaking up.
Is there a coffee shop or something near your house?
Not in my house, no.
No, I mean like nearby your house. Where are you at now? Like, is there a coffee shop or a restaurant or?
There is a coffee shop, yes, but I do not know what it is called. I have not been in there, like I say. I've only been here for a 2 day now. Well, a one and a half a day.
Right. Because I have to know where to come.
Yes, sir. Unless you can come to my house, sir. But I obviously cannot give you the direction.
Yeah, if you've given me the right city and zip code and address, I can find the house. But I just thought you might feel more comfortable, at a restaurant or something. But that's
Yes, sir.
okay. I can
Yes,
come
sir.
to the house.
Do you know the area where I am at now at all?
Yes, I know the Jackson area.
Do you know any cafe that is near to me, or a Walmart or something like this, where we could meet?
Well, I just have to go on the internet and see where exactly your street is, and then I'll be able to find something.
Yes, sir.
If you want to give me a call back, and in a couple hours, I can give you that answer.
Yes, sir. I don't know if I can give you a call back because I am running out of money for the telephone.
Why don't you buy a prepaid phone so that you can call me? You know what that is, a prepaid phone?
No, a what?
How long were you in prison? About 20 years?
Yes, about the 20.
Okay.
22 years, I think it was. Like I say, I don't,
All right,
you
no, I
kind of
understand.
lose
So that's
all track of the time.
no, that's okay. All right, so a prepaid phone, it's going to be a little difficult because you're probably not familiar with those things, but you can buy one at Walmart, and you just go and ask them for a prepaid phone. You buy
And are
so
you a
many minutes.
plug-it into the wall?
You can,
I
well,
know that
no,
you. I
you.
know that you buy the phone, and I can remember that you buy the phone. And you plug it into the wall.
Well, you plug it into the wall to charge it, but then after that, of course, you can
No, you
just
have to
use it
plug.
on
No,
the
no, no,
battery.
no. Charge it. No, you plug it into the wall for the telephone line and it pick up. And
No, no,
you
no, no,
press
no.
you press the circle. With the circle
No.
has got the numbers with the holes in, and you press
No,
it
no,
round.
no, no. This is a cell phone. It's completely different.
Oh, you have to explain to me. I am not hearing of this at all ever. What, a cell
Okay.
phone? A
It's
what?
a cell phone.
A cell phone? How are you spelling this?
CELL. It's a portable.
CELL.
Yeah, you carry it around with you,
Yes, I
and it.
know that word, a cell. Yes.
You don't have any friends here that can help you, huh?
I know a nobody. I have never ever been to a Mississippi before. I have been here a 1 day and a half, maybe just I don't know how many hours.
Okay. All right.
So
Well.
please explain it to me about this cell phone. I can buy one from a Walmart, did you say?
Yes, you can buy one from Walmart, and you go in there and just tell them you want a prepaid cell phone.
Yes, please. Let me
They
write
have different.
this down. Let me. I've got a pen and a piece of a paper. Let me please.
Okay.
Wait a minute. Let me just. I guess that the red down loud. Now, I take it the top off the pen. And let me just get a piece of paper. Yes, sir. So it is Walmart, and it is called a cell.
Prepaid, prepaid cell phone.
And how are you spelling
Those
this?
are cheap. Those are cheaper than, the other ones.
Prepaying?
Prepaid. In other words,
Please be
you're going to
spelling.
pay. You're going to pay ahead of time for a month's worth of minutes,
Yeah,
so that you can use your phone to call.
please be spelling this to me. Please be spelling this to me. The pre.
Oh, okay. Pre, P-R-E,
PRE.
P-A-I-D.
P-A-I-D.
Correct. Prepaid cell phone. C-E-L-L.
Cell.
Cell.
Yes.
Just like the cell that you were in.
Yes, I know. That's
it's
what I
phone.
Said before. Yes, I know. That is not
yeah,
a very
I know.
Good
it's a little confusing.
That is not a very good word.
I know. I'm so sorry.
I have just gone out and I don't want to buy at Walmart a new in the jail.
I know. I understand. I didn't even think of that until just now. Okay. All right. So,
a prepaid cell phone.
No, just go to the electronics section in Walmart, and they'll help you out. They'll explain everything to you.
And how do this phone? I know nothing about this cell phone. Please tell me a bit about it.
But just go to the lady at Walmart in the electronics department.
When I buy it, do I have to take it home and plug it into the wall?
You'll have to charge it up, yes.
Yes,
you'll have
charge
to charge
it up,
the battery.
Yes, but to plug it in, I don't know if there is a phone connection. Is that the right word?
No. It's electricity.
No. Where you plug it in, you have to plug it in.
No, it's electricity. No, you don't plug it in. It's run by satellite. It's electricity.
Run by a what? Satellite? I've heard of that.
Satellite. It's run by satellite. You just have to plug it in to charge the battery up.
Oh, I see. So
right.
you
kind of like the old fashioned. It's kind of like the portable phones we used to have. They ran by electricity, and you know, you could use a second phone. But I don't want to confuse you. Just talk to the lady at Walmart. She'll explain everything to you.
Yes, sir.
And after you get it charged up, call me back, and we can, and then I will know then where there's a place close by your home.
Yes, sir. Okay, I will do this, sir. I will do this, sir. What time does the Walmart close?
Oh, they're open till late.
Are they late? I know the summer Walmart. I don't know about now, but they used to be open some for a little bit of the day, and some open for all a day and all a night. Isn't this?
Well, they're going to be in Jackson. The Walmart's probably going to be open till 11 or 12 o'clock tonight.
Oh, that'll be fine. That will give me a lot of good time then.
And then just call me back after your phone charges up, and then I'll have a number that I can call you back on, and then we can get together on Monday.
Okay, that sounds great. And your name was?
Right.
Your name was?
My name is Gladys.
Gladys. Okay,
yes.
Then, Gladys. Thank you so very much.
You're welcome.
And we will get this sorted out. And
right.
when the money is found, I will be able to pay for the private investigating, and then I will be able to pay £500,000 for the thank you for the private investigating.
Okay. We'll talk on Monday then.
Yes, please. I'm looking forward to it.
Okay, thanks, Mario.
Oh, thank you so much.
All right. Bye-bye.
Goodbye.